Hello friends. Now, stress, word stress. English, stress is a must. One of the syllables in a word must take a stress. Or what do you call accent? I don't know. Some people call it accent. Accent has some other meaning also. As you can say, accent means the way you talk. See, British accent is British accent, American accent, Australian accent. So, in the last class we saw disyllabic words. Nouns take stress on the first syllable. For example, we saw increase. Increase. So, this is noun. Increase. But verbs take the second syllable. See? Increase. Increase. So, stress has that effect also. If you move the stress, noun will become verb. Understand? That's also a point to be noted. Now, disyllabic means two syllables. Well, has two syllables. Disyllabic prepositions are there. They also take their stress or accent on the second syllable. For example, you see a long. See? A long. You see? A long. Understand? A side. Long. A side. Between. Between. See? Stress. Between. There is a stress. Between. Along. Aside. Between. Between. Understand? Between. And you also have along. Yes. You have got around. Round. Around. You don't say around. You say around. They are around. Listen. Around. Among. See that? But there, please do not think that these are absolute and general rules. We can say 80% of, whenever we give a guidance, I don't even call it a rule, but a guidance like this, we can say 80% of the words, they behave like this. 20% are always out. Listen. So, I told you now, best thing is, you learn each word, and when you learn any word, learn this stress. Okay. So, now we have covered stress, disyllabic words, noun. Noun we have seen. Second, verb we have seen. And third, we have seen prepositions. Prepositions. Here you can see this on first syllable. Here second syllable. Here also second syllable. Second syllable stress. Okay. Now we have got some, what I must say is, some kind of guidance that we can see. See, words ending in ER, OR, LY. So that is the fourth one. Words, whether it is noun, adjective or whatever it is. Words, the only ending is important here. ER, OR, or LY. You know, what are they called? They are called the suffixes. Suffix, what is suffix means? A syllable added at the end of a word. Example, king. Plus dumb, kingdom, and dumb is a suffix. Understand? Dumb is a suffix. Quick plus li, quickly. Li is a suffix. Edit plus or, editor. The or is a suffix. Give plus ear, one evil giver. Then ear is a suffix. Suffix. Do plus ER. Doer. The ER is a suffix. So, in such cases, the stress is on the suffix. Oh, sorry, in the first syllable. Sorry. No, the suffix. That's another rule. So, stress is on the first syllable. First syllable stress. Understand? So we can say like this first. First syllable stress. You have words like writer. See? Writer. Right ear. Writer. Doer. Doer. See that? And writer, doer. There you have got timer, slider, rider, timer, timer, rider, rider, timer, rider, slider, 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 the doer. Already we have that, isn't it? Then fresher. And we have got words like pager, yes, pager, pager, pager. See that? So words ending in, this is the question, ending in suffix ya. Suffix is, of course, write plus ya, writer, do plus ya, doer, time plus ya, time. Then you will ask me, what happened to the one, the other e? And you have two e, you need, you can drop one. That is common sense, I think. Is okay? Okay, rider, slider. Now here, the stress is on the first syllable. Understand? You say, we don't say writer, no. What do you say? Writer. That's it. Writer. Doer. Timer. Rider. Slider. Fresher. Pager. Listen. First syllable. Now or. You have got a edit. Edit plus or editor. Audit plus or auditor. Isn't it? Sail plus or sailor. Sailor. Then creditor. Credit plus or creditor. Debitor. Debit plus or debitor, creditor, debitor, auditor. Understand? Now here, this is or is the suffix. So, editor, auditor, sailor, creditor, debitor. We don't say editor. We don't say creditor. No. Sailor. So that is, again, we must say, it comes automatically. Understand? And now next is li, isn't it? Yes. Order. Order. Plus li, orderly. Quick. Plus li, quickly. See that? Quickly. You don't say, quickly. Love. Plus li, lovely. Isn't it? Sad plus li, sadly, sadly, loudly, sadly. So the stress is on the sure plus li, surely, isn't it? Sure plus li, surely. So we will say like this, lovely, sadly, then surely, orderly, quickly. Now again here, 80% of the words, not 100%. There's nothing like 100%. Understand? Yeah. So this is the fourth rule, if you want to say, you can keep in your mind. That is, as far as word stress is concerned, this is the fourth rule. Now we have got another thing. You have got, you know this some very interesting suffixes are there, like double E. Again, the fifth point we are coming, fifth rule, double E, ESC, E, double E, ESC, right? Employee, interviewee, isn't it? And then you have got a, you know that, isn't it? ESC, double ER, That is again suffix, you know, double er, suffix you write like this. Double er. You have got seer. You have seer, isn't it? Scrutineer, engineer, you have got. Then IQE. IQE. That is antique, unique. You have got words like that. Then TETTE. E-T-T-E, cassette, 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 isn't it? E-T-T-E, E-T-T-E, you got a etiquette, etiquette, that's right. Now let's see, where will you put the stress? Stress is on the suffix. Here we have got a suffix, but stress is on the first syllable. And in this case, stress is on the suffix. Stress on suffix. Understand? So, employee. Employee. Here is the stress. Employee. And embryo. Comes like that. This. What do you call? You got a natural way of saying no. Employee will answer. Interviewee. Isn't it? Interviewee. Interviewee. Committee. Isn't it? Committee. 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 Interviewee. Committee, yes, committee. Committee, no, we don't say committee, committee, isn't it? Committee, nominee, yes, no, nominee, consignee, consignee, see that? So that is the thing, first. So you have got suffixes like this, then the stress is on the suffix. Understand? Or you can say the last part. Suffix is the last part. Either you can say suffix or you can say the last part. Then you have got archdiocese. Yes. Archdiocese. Yes. Archdiocese. Archdiocese, you can say. Understand that? Then or you can say words like sociologies. Yes. So archdiocese, sociologies, understand? Legalese. So these are examples. And now you have got W here. There are plenty of examples. Auctioneer, scrutineer, many words are there. Engineer, we have already seen that. Yes, auctioneer, engineer, see that? Scrutineer, engineer. Scrutineer, then what is it? Charioteer. So that is on the last part. Or you have the last syllable. Understand? Next one is IQES. You can have oblique. We are using that. Oblique. See that? Oblique. Antique. IQE, antique, antique, oblique, physique, unique, physique, 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 oui, oui, physique, unique, unique, IQE, physique, unique, technique, yes, a simple word, technique, technique, technique. See, look at that. The last one. Understand, last one. Now you like cassette, 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 E-double-T-E, cassette, isn't it? Floweret, flower, floweret, cassette, 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 flower, etiquette. So here, this is floweret. See, that's all. E-T-T, floweret, etiquette, etiquette, symbol. This is also 90% rule. There are exceptions. Any rule has exceptions. You simply cannot. That's the challenge of learning English. Verses you must master. Understand? Now, the best way to master is when you study a new word, study the stress. When you study a sentence, also you try to understand the intonation, the melody of that. Then you just speak like the native speaker. Is that your mission? No. Okay then. So once again, you have got the suffixes like double E. See that? Means the last syllable you can say. Last syllable. What are the suffixes? Employee, interviewee, committee, nominee, consignee. See that? Then is archdiocese, sociologies, legalese. Okay, next. Auctioneer, engineer, scrutineer, charioteer. We don't say charioteer, but charioteer. Tear. Then technique, oblique, antique, physique, unique. We don't say unique. We say unique. You are a unique person. Cassette, floweret, etiquette. Is that clear? Do you think it's simple? Simple, if you remember it like that. Alright? Very good, fine. So now we have seen, we have got five rules, so to say. Five rules. But all the rules, they are rules because they have got, they are exemptions. Understand? Only rules are exemptions. If no rule, no exemption. Right? Okay. Now the fifth one is, sixth one, so to say. Sixth one we are going to learn is, you have again got the suffixes. So the suffixes like, you can say, ik, 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 S-I-O-N, T-A-O-N, shun, isn't it? Ik, automatic, automatic. Automatic. So here what happens, you know, here you have to count from the last, second syllable from the last. So here it is, first syllable, then stress is automatic. 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 Understand? Oh. Energetic. energetic, energetic, automatic, automatic, energetic is an energetic fluid, not energy fluid, energetic, automatic, everything is automatic, so this is not automatic, don't you see the difference, see that, even within that word there is some melody, automatic, energetic, next one is S-I-I-O, division, division, division for, not division for, division, division, understand, division, like revision, revision of explosion. Suppose you read these words like this, automatic, energetic, division, revision, explosion. And now you read it like this, automatic, energetic, division, revision, explosion. If you read like this and study, you know, it will be there, you automatically will be saying, automatic. So that you will be saying like that, revision. Understand? Seclusion. 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 See? Seclusion. And what is the next one? T-A-U-N. Yes. You can say now. Count from the last second syllable. So you have what is nation. 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 Understand? Location. 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 Understand? Location. Nation. Donation. D-O-N-A-T-I-O-N. Donation. Not donation. Don't give donation. Listen. Infection. Infection. So this is how it is. So that's the sixth rule. Ik. Shen. Shen. So second from the last. You can see now. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is first syllable in the last syllable. So automatic, energetic, division, revision, explosion, seclusion, nation. So here nation, location, donation, infection, the symptomatic, symptomatic, you say. Symptomatic. Listen. Duration. Symptomatic. Duration. Vocation. 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 What's your vocation? Not don't say vocation, but v labio dental waist forget it. Yes. V vocation duration creation. So creation. These are rules. Understand? Now, I think you are following, no? Okay? So, this is where stress second. And now you have another interesting rule. That is, I would say that, you can use it. So the seventh one. That is, if a word ends in Y, or a consonant, the stress is on the, usually what happens is, you stress on the first syllable. For example, words like rarity. See, ends in Y. So, rarity. Gradient. Here, ends in a gradient, ends in a consonant. Therefore, first syllable. Gradient. See that? Then again, say optimal. Optimal. Words like this. Optimal. So, first syllable. But this is, you can have a guidance like this, but it's not a rule. You can't call it a rule. Why you are a consonant? There are many words ending in consonant. At the same time, they have got their syllable, their stress in different syllables. Understand? So, for example, accomplishment. We don't say accomplishment. So, that you cannot say. But, as a guidance, you can use it, that's all. So, okay. So, this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for today, rules, they are valid. They have got some strength, the support. They have got support. There are many people to support them. The last one, again, as a kind of guidance. Okay. So, here, let's think about this. Nouns. Once again, nouns. Come on, give any noun. Disyllabic. Monosyllabic words, they have their stress. There's only one syllable, so it is stressed. Understand? When the problem comes, when not the problem, but the challenge. The challenge, the game. The game we have to play with the disyllabic, trisyllabic, and things like that. So, noun, first syllable. Verb, second syllable. Prepositions, second syllable. Then, ER, OR, LY, first syllable. We have seen a carpenter. Carpenter. We don't say carpenter, no. Carpenter. Giver. Isn't it? Mover. Prime mover. God is said to be the prime mover. Prime. The definition of God is this. Prime mover. Prime. Prime mover. Prime mover means the first person to move. The first move is made by God. So, God is prime mover. That's what the theologians say, and also philosophers also say, prime mover. This writer, timer, see, this or editor. Sorry, first syllable, editor. Quickly. Then you have got words like but. You have got exceptions out there, of course, I told you. Quickly, then a simple word. Similarly. And then, W-E-S-E-R, you have got the suffix. Or the last part you can say. See the employee, after the yosis, isn't it? After the yosis, and you have got a chariot engineer. That is an engineer. Yes. IQE antique. ETDE cassette. The simple number. Ik Shan Shan. You have got it on the last. From the end you have to count. Come back. That is, you have to. Last syllable you take, and then immediately before that. Or the second from the last, that's a simple thing to do. Second from the last, you have got words like automatic, energetic, and so on. And the last one, you can keep it as a guidance, Y or any consonant. There are many words ending in consonants, but you can say some of these, you can try. Well, another interesting thing about stress is, it comes naturally. Most of the time it comes naturally. Only when you have a long word like anti-disestablishmentarianism. Nobody uses that, I think. What sense can you use it? In such words, you have got many, not one but two. You'll find two, if a primary and secondary. Secondary is below. Examination, I told you. Very often I take that example wrong. Examination. Examination. See here. Examination. This is all. And secondary stress is marked below. Examination. You know, stress is required for you to take the word forward. Some energy you are giving. Otherwise, it will be like examination. We will have our examination on that day. Examination. Don't you think it's better to put the stress, mark the stress and learn a new word? Sure, no doubt about it. Try that. From now on, this. Whatever you have done, you have learned, you need not unlearn. That's not required. New words, if you, when you are learning a new word, and you learn the stress also, then what happens is, the old will also become new to you, in the sense that automatically you will be able to read that word with the stress, and with the correct stress. So let us be optimistic, let's take this as a challenge, and see that we'll be able to, see that whether we can learn all the new words. You will be learning now, you are plus two, secondary level. Or secondary level or higher secondary level, whatever it is. You are going to learn lakhs and lakhs of words for your future use. Then, definitely, you can think of the stress and also you can read this, pronounce these words with stress. Stress is a supra-segmental feature. Means, it can alter the meaning of words. We have already seen. Noun can become verb. Verb can become noun. Understand? That is the area where it becomes a supra-segmental feature. Alright? I hope that you are enjoying my class and you are benefiting out of it. And therefore, with great optimism, and maybe what I must say of my satisfaction. I have got great satisfaction. If you are benefiting out of these things, then see you again. Till we see, bye. So we'll have just one more class on stress. Few more examples and few more rules I will be giving. And with that, this area will be over. And this is it difficult for you to remember this thing? It's seven guidance or seven rules. One of the examples you remember, the noun. You understand? Increase, verb, increase, preposition, along, here, giver, editor, and then lovely, and this one, employee, see that, ESE, legalese, WR, seer, see that, IQE, that is, physique, E-T-T-E, cassette, and that is stress on the last one. Here, exemption, last but one, or second from the last. You can say automatic, energetic, yes. Vision, revision, shun, nation, but there are only two words. So that way, so I think it's okay. Fine, see you again. Till we meet, have a nice time. Enjoy your life. Take things very easy. Bye.